It's only a matter of time before humans step foot on a new planetary body in our solar system. And with that in mind, NASA Goddard Space Flight Center is learning how to develop instruments that would be used by humans to conduct exploration and research. One research program actively involved in this pursuit sits in isolation in a habitat on the slopes of the Mauna Loa volcano in Hawaii. It's called High Seas, and the Mars-like conditions and geology of the landscape allow the crews there to perform field tests and experiments that give a mission simulation an extra dose of realism. Today, scientists from NASA Goddard are nearby, deploying an instrument known as the mini-LHR, which measures methane and carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. The goal is to allow the High Seas crew to simulate how an astronaut would interact with the instrument on another planet. The task is also designed to explore how NASA might approach an in-mission training with a new instrument that a crew has never seen before. This High Seas adventure, therefore, has numerous components for NASA to monitor. And it all begins with the crew making the long trek over the old lava flows to the site of the mini-LHR. Once there, the team will get the instrument working so that it can start its actual data collection. On another planet, this atmospheric data would be important for understanding elements related to climate and habitability. The interaction between the High Seas team and the mini-LHR is in itself a test, designed to monitor changes in the environment that are occurring naturally or as a response to the human presence. By participating in this type of fieldwork study, NASA Goddard's instrument field team is making great strides towards the larger mission of getting humans on the surface of another planet. And as the High Seas crew can attest, doing so is no easy walk in the park.